Welcome to Examsdaily YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see the daily current affairs of September 27 and 28, 2019. Before that, the Zorian subscriber Examsdaily YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and also do not forget to click the bell button to get updates from our YouTube channel. First, we can see the answers for the previous day's current affairs question. First question, which state's forest department is set to roll out the first ever tree census? The answer is Karnataka. Second question, Hiroshima bombing was held in which year? The answer is 1945. Third question. Second All India Annual Conference of IIS Officers was held in which city? The answer is New Delhi. Fourth question. Workshop on Role of Technology in Reuniting Missing Children and Trafficked Persons was held in which city? The answer is New Delhi. Fifth question. Who won the British Open Golf Tournament? The answer is Hinaka Shibuno. September 27, World Tourism Day. The World Tourism Day is observed on September 27 each year. The international tourist arrival worldwide have grown from 25 million in 1950 to nearly 1.3 billion now. Similarly, international tourism revenues earned by destinations around the world have grown from $2 billion in the year 1950 to 1260 trillion in the year 2015. The sector represents an estimated 10% of the world's GDP and 1 in 10 jobs globally. So to recognize this tourism sector, the World Tourism Day is being observed on September 27. So here we can expect the question that the World Tourism Day is observed on which date? The answer is September 27. September 28, International Day for Universal Access to Information. Since the year 2016, UNESCO marks the 28th September as the International Day for Universal Access to Information, following the adoption of the 38C Resolution 57, declaring 28th September of every year as the International Day for Universal Access to Information. So the theme of this year's celebration is Leaving No One Behind. So this UNESCO, the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, it is a specialized agency of the UN and its headquarters situated in Paris, which is in France. It is France capital. So it was formed on 4th November 1945. That is, UNESCO formed on 4th November 1945. And the Director General of the UNESCO is Audrey Azoulay. So here we can expect the question that the International Day for Universal Access to Information is observed on which date? The answer is September 28. September 28, World Rabies Day. The World Rabies Day is celebrated annually to raise the awareness about rabies prevention and to highlight the progress in defeating this horrifying disease. The 28th September also marks the anniversary of Louis Pasteur's death, the French chemist and microbiologist who developed the first rabies vaccine. This Louis Pasteur, born on December 27, 1822, and died on September 28, 1895. So this day is remembered as the World Rabies Day. And he was a French biologist, microbiologist and chemist renowned for his discoveries of the principle of vaccination, microbial fermentation and pasteurization. So here we can expect the question that the World Rabies Day is observed on which date? The answer is September 28. Second Singapore India Hackathon to be organized at IIT Madras from September 28. To promote the innovation, second edition of Singapore India Hackathon will be organized at IIT Madras, Chennai from September 28 to 29, 2019. The India-Singapore Hackathon is the first of its kind joint international hackathon between the India and Singapore, during which the selected bright students from India and Singapore will work in collaboration to develop the innovative and out-of-the-box solution for some of the daunting problems faced by our societies. So here we can expect the question, where was the second Singapore India Hackathon organized from September 28? The answer is IIT Madras. Metro Rail Project in Bhopal. In Madhya Pradesh, the Chief Minister Kamal Nath recently laid the foundation stone and performed the puja of the Metro Rail Project in Bhopal. The Chief Minister Kamal Nath announced that Bhopal Metro will be known as Bhoj Metro. A target has been set to complete the Metro Rail Project in Bhopal by the year 2023. So this Metro Rail, that is Rapid Transit System, the first rapid transit system in India is the Kolkata Metro, which started operation in the year 1984. So the Kolkata Metro is the first rapid transit system in India. The Delhi Metro has the largest network in the entire country and the newest metro was opened in Nagpur on 8 March 2019. So this is the latest metro, that is Nagpur Metro, which was opened on 8 March 2019. And now the foundation stone has been laid for the Metro Rail Project in Bhopal. So here we can expect the question, where was the foundation stone laid for Metro Rail Project recently? The answer is Bhopal. Saudi Arabia to offer tourist visa for first time. Saudi Arabia said that it will offer tourist visa for the first time, opening up the kingdom to holidaymakers as part of a push to diversify its economy away from oil. Kickstarting tourism is one of the centerpieces of Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman's Vision 2030 reform program to prepare the biggest Arab economy for a post-oil era. So here we can expect the question that which country is to offer tourist visa for first time? The answer is Saudi Arabia. First indigenous fuel cell system. The President of India, Shri Ramnath Kovind, unveiled the first indigenous high temperature fuel cell system developed by the CSIR, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, in partnership with Indian industries under India's flagship program named New Millennium Indian Technology Leadership Initiative on the occasion of CSIR Foundation Day at Vinyan Bhavan, New Delhi. The CSIR, that is the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, it was established by the Government of India in September of the year 1942, and it is an autonomous body that has emerged as the largest research and development organization in India. The president of CSIR is Prime Minister of India, and the Director General is Shekhar C. Mande, and the headquarter of the CSIR is in New Delhi. So here we can expect the question that where was the first indigenous fuel cell system developed by CSIR unveiled? The answer is New Delhi. Project Netra. The Indian Space Research Organization ISRO initiated the Project Netra, an early warning system in space to detect the debris and other. The space debris could be a floating particles from dead satellites or rocket parts that stay in orbit for many years. This Netra effort would make India a part of international efforts toward tracking, warning about and mitigating the space debris. So here we can expect a question that what is the name of the project created to detect debris in space by ISRO? The answer is Project Netra. International Conference Cum Biosella meet in Agartala. The Agricultural and Processed Food Product Export Development Authority under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India, in cooperation with the Government of Tripura, organized an International Conference Cum Biosella meet in Agartala to showcase the export potential of agriculture product from the Northeast region and Tripura in particular. This APEDA, Agriculture and Processed Food Product Export Development Authority, is an apex body under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India. And this APEDA is responsible for the export promotion of agriculture products. And this APEDA was formed in the year 1986, and its headquarters are situated in New Delhi, and its chairman is Pavan Kumar. So here we can expect the question, where was the International Conference Cum Biosella meet organized to showcase the export potential of agriculture products from the Northeast region held? The answer is Agartala. Bulgaria's Kristalina Georgieva appointed as the new IMF chief. Bulgaria's Kristalina Georgieva has been selected as the new head of the IMF, International Monetary Fund. She is the first person from an emerging market economy to lead the IMF. The Economist, Bulgaria's Kristalina Georgieva succeeds Christian Lagarde for a 5-year term from October. This IMF, International Monetary Fund, is an international organization. It consists of 189 countries and is headquartered situated in Washington, D.C. And this IMF formed on 27th December 1945. And the chief economist of IMF is Geeta Gopinath. So here we can expect the question that who has been appointed as the new IMF chief? The answer is Kristalina Georgieva. Rupa Gurunath takes over as TNCA president. The 45-year-old Rupa Gurunath, whole-time director India Cements, was elected unopposed as the president of the Tamil Nadu Cricket Association and will be in office for a term of 3 years. This TNCA, Tamil Nadu Cricket Association, is the governing body of cricket activities in Tamil Nadu state of India and the Tamil Nadu's cricket team, and it is affiliated to the Board of Control for Cricket in India. TNCA is one of the permanent test centers of the BCCI. So here we can expect the question that who has been elected as the TNCA president? The answer is Rupa Gurunath. Now we can see the daily current affairs questions of the year 2019. We know the answer for these questions. Please give your answer in the comment section, and we will give you the answer for these questions in the next day current affairs video. First question, National Handloom Day is observed on which date? Second question, who was the country's first full-time women foreign minister? Third question, 22nd National Conference on E-Governance 2019 was held in which state? Fourth question, which peak is the highest peak in the European continent? Fifth question, International Day of the World's Indigenous People is observed on which date? In the description box below this video, we have given the daily, weekly and monthly current affairs PDF and the videos link, and also we have given the quiz link. Please make use of it and be successful in your exam. Thank you.